What's up, guys? This is Jeremiah with RippedTide Gaming, and today we're diving into episode number 4 of our playthrough of Death Stranding. Now, in real time, it's been about a week since I played the game. Last time, I went out of town, went actually back home to Pittsburgh to celebrate Thanksgiving, and just haven't had time to jump on in. Subsequently, I posted a Days Gone video and a Call of Duty Modern Warfare that just went live today. So I have a handful more of episodes of each of those to finish out the series, finish through the storyline in both. You'll see BB and Norman behind me hanging out as always. Let me go ahead and continue while this is loading. I will dive right keep you guys up to date with what's been happening with the channel. We've had a flurry of new progress, so appreciate any of you new subscribers. I really like new people joining in, and please everybody just to engage, like, comment, subscribe, share. That way we can continue to grow this community. I really am getting closer and closer to my goal of 100 subscribers by the end of 2019, so please help with that. Truly appreciate it, and please just let me know what you guys think. Really like to see feedback. If you like shorter videos, if you like longer videos, if you'd like me just to kind of cut to just the good parts, I can definitely do that. Let me know what you think. This one I'm going to keep unedited and see kind of what the feedback is on this. And I know that where I left off, we were still on chapter 2, and I think we still have a good ways to go with chapter 2 before we get to chapter 3. I know that's kind of where everybody's telling me to go. So let's dive in, hit resume game, and we are in our room. Examine figures. Thanks, Norman. Oh, buddy, more figures. I guess since I got captured by the BTs, that's why that's showing up there. I think at the end of last episode, I did. Let's see if I can create some more weapons. At the end of last episode, I did use my monster. So let's see. Nice. Let's see what we can get here. See if we can get any sort of grenades or something to help us with the PTs moving forward.
Nice.
I love that it's a little advertisement for Norman Reedus, his show. Funny. Okay, I think I did everything I need to do here. Alright. Let's examine our weapon rack. We should have some weapons now, huh? EX grenade, okay. All right. So let's see, my BB. How are you, sir? All right, buddy, we have to head out though. So, let's go ahead and leave our private room. Get this show on the road, shall we? Oh.
agreed on. You said you'd do everything in your power to save BB.
Is that Bridget's voice?
System woman in a mask who's done nothing but lie to me.
Interesting.
Beginning scan. Scanning Bridget's ID. Verifying ID.
Sam.
What's up, Deadman?
Out of curiosity, how's it doing at the moment?
Before I answer that...
Something wrong?
When I hook up my BB, I see things.
What kind of things?
Like a face, someone I don't know, calling to me. There's this room, too, with other people talking, but I can't make out the words.
Lead-through effect. Didn't I warn you about this? You're mistaking the BB's memories for your own. They're false flashbacks, nothing more. Let me explain.
Come on, dead man.
A BB is harvested from its steel mother at around 28 weeks and placed in a pod. To be clear, this is before it's even born. The procedure halts its development. But even at 28 weeks, its sensory systems have matured enough to process external stimuli. It is more than capable of encoding this information into memories, which can bleed into yours via your connection.
So who's the man I saw?
Someone from the medical team, maybe? Or a BB technician? Does it matter? The BB has been in circulation for a while now. It's been handled by a lot of people. How should I know which one made an impression?
Because you're the expert.
No one's an expert, Sam. BBs were developed decades ago in secret. They're your quintessential black boxes. We may use them, but we don't truly understand them. Believe me, I've been trying to learn more, but almost...
I don't know why, but I don't trust Deadman.
If I find anything out, I'll tell you, all right? Deadman's honor.
Sam, check the delivery terminal and review the list of orders.
While you're resting, I ran some network diagnostics. Perillion monitoring and holographic systems are nominal. Unfortunately, our printer is offline. I know. After all the trouble you went through to bring us those materials. This one's on us. We ordered a part a while back, but it never arrived. The printer needs it to communicate with the chiral network. Mules must have snatched it, caught that porter en route or something.
Okay.
If I'm right, they'll have taken it to their drop site, which is smack dab in the middle of their territory. Don't suppose you'd be up for stealing us our property back?
Sure.
Can't think of anyone more qualified than you.
So that means I can't print anything, right? There we go. So I'm not really sure what recycling the resin does, but it seems like the right thing to do.
Thank you for your continued support.
Weird. Chiral crystals. Okay.
Mama's added a watchtower schematic to your PCC.
Okay.
If you... you never know when you'll need to recon an area.
Alright. So what all do I have right now? I've got a climbing PCC, PCC, PCC. Hang on, tool rack. Let's do that. There we go. It's got nothing. Head out, let's do this. We're ready for war.
That thing you're holding is a crystal collector. Now, as the name suggests, it provides secure storage for any crystals you gather.
Hey, Hartman. Okay. Yep.
Chiral crystals appear gold to the naked eye and have frequently found in formations resembling human handprints. Surrounding rocks and debris tend to float a few
feet on the ground.
And they are most commonly found in areas with high precipitation. Got all that?
Yeah, rave, where BTs will be, right?
That's your trifecta.
Okay.
Look for these three things and you'll find the crystals.
Yes, sir.
If you've been especially observant, then perhaps you already know where to look.
Thank you for your contribution.
So, hold on. I need to check... fabricate equipment. Okay, so I don't see the weapons or anything. Alright. Let's do this. Let's head out. Hey, thanks.
Beginning scan. Have a pleasant journey.
Name's Sam. Anybody home? Sam.
All right, can we use this motorcycle yet?
Weapons restrictions lifted.
I was looking for a recharge station. Which way are we headed?
Don't mind me.
Don't mind me.
Suppose this is where I'm going.
Sam, chiral crystals are pretty small and can be difficult to spot with the naked eye. I'd advise you to use your ultra deck to point you in the right direction. If you want to survey a wider area, though, you might consider building a watchtower and relying on its sensors.
Let's see here. All right, we're good. So I wonder if we're, since it's raining already, if we're heading back into BT territory. How many crystals we're supposed to get.
Almost there.
Definitely heading into BT land.
Yeah, I feel you.
Let's head back and do this. Because I know they'll need one and then the other. So if I head back and posit what I've gotten thus far, that will help. Get up, man. So that's what happens when I run out of stamina, huh? This place is kind of landlocked.
Okay. Stranding's to blame for all of this. The gaze
right. Is
the fall of America, everything. It warped the world beyond recognition. You Humanity had to scramble like rats fleeing a sinking ship. But there's nowhere else to go. There's no future living like this. If we're to survive, we need to find another way. A way to overcome the BTs, the Death Stranding, the whole damn mess.
Take off. Ooh. Because it's raining, I'm sliding everywhere.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges.
Sam, Hyrule crystal deliveries are a little different from usual. The process is pretty simple, though. Access the delivery terminal to drop off any Hyrule crystals you're carrying.
Got it. That was weird. And they didn't tell me how to do that. I just laying around.
Got some chiral crystals for us? These crystals only form in places with elevated chirillium levels. Which makes me wonder if expanding the network had something to do with it.
Probably.
Damn, son. That is a lot of crystals. Maintenance and R&D will both get their fill, looks like.
You're welcome.
Excess chiral crystals can be deposited at any facility. These... Good work, Sam.
Thank you.
It seems your connection level is increasing. As your connection level increases, larger quantities of resources will be made available to you at our facilities.
What is this?
That's container repair spray for patching up cargo containers. Good for dealing with timefall degradation and all that. Useful stuff if you and your cargo have been through the ringer. We've added it to your supplies list, so it's readily available if and when you need it.
Awesome, thank you.
Between elevated chirillium levels and increased crystal formation. This may well be the result of the network's expansion. You needn't worry though, local chiral density is still within an acceptable range. If you find any more, be sure to collect it. You'll be well rewarded. Mm-hmm.
If you come into more chiral crystals, you can submit them.
These guys telling me stuff.
And you can deposit other resources too, along with any items you don't need. Everything has its value. What we don't use as is can be broken down into components for R&D and other applications.
Understood.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
Forget how to create the little little signs that everybody's leaving up there. So I think those are important. Over the place here, man.
Nice. There we go.
Pick up as much as we can, whatever we can. I love this. This is pretty addicting out here in the wild. What's this guy have to say? if I stay all the way over here, if that'll help. Stay out of the BT land. So I don't really feel like messing with them. And so I got some weapons to fight against them. Well, okay, I see one over there. Nuts, but I don't see them. Okay. I feel like I feel myself like holding my breath as doing that. I think I took a good path though this way. Yeah, the other deck, he's just chilling. No big issues here. Okay. Awesome. Made it out of BT land.
There we go.
This way, man.
Nice.
So far, I must say this game does a great job, if nothing else, with atmosphere. Like, I was literally just tense and holding my breath throughout that entire thing. But meanwhile, you know, this far I know, since I have no weapons, that I try to fight them off. In worst case scenario, I'll just run. I'll just run from the big old BT bosses, because I do not want to create a void out, especially that close to that city that I just... have been becoming friends with, you know? Let's see here. Let's use one of our ladders. Yeah, not necessary. Oh, maybe it is. Okay. Whoops. Let's use... I bet you I'll have to make a delivery to that person.
Weapons some restrictions point. Lifted.
Can I place this right? So I'm gonna check out the Mule location. Let's use that watchtower. I think I only see two mules. Interesting. Oops. I always see the baby. Too, BB. Alright, buddy. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for being a goof. ready to do some battle. Sure. How far these guys can see, like what the sight line is or anything like that. If I can hide in this tall grass, maybe? Same time as his buddy. Where's the thing that I'm looking for? There you wake up somebody else, man. What? Get out of here. I went over here and beat these guys up for no reason. Oh, man. So I guess we have to go back to Capital Knot City, drop off what I can, and then continue on. Goodness, went the wrong way. Bummer. Well, if you guys are enjoying what I'm doing here, please leave a like, comment down below, subscribe if you're not done so already, and please share. That way we can continue to grow this community. Try and gingerly walk down this hill. There we go. Can't believe how thrown off I was. I mean, that was fun, getting the experience to actually fight these guys. That was pretty cool. It felt like a little bit of a side mission. Unintended side mission. Alright. Drone back into BT land. Seem to follow my footsteps. Thank you.
This looks like the way to go.
Let's grab some more chiral. So dark. And I feel like my chest is getting tight as I'm walking through this, man. Looks like the another person went the same way I did. So my shoes are roughly 50%, so I think I need to switch them. Not real sure how to do that just yet. Let's get out of here. Let's see. All right, we're good. Thank you.
There we go.
Changing footwear now. Or not. But it worked. Okay. Yeah, because we don't want to ruin our freshly repaired boxes, you know?
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. All weapons will remain locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Thank you.
Decontaminating suit. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Someone's laughing.
All right, so... Shield handler, I've upgraded. Very nice.
Thank you for your contribution.
So I wonder if I just go to... Do a BB sound right here.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
All right, let's head up there. I think what I'll do, since this has been a bit of a longer episode without any story specifically, I might finish this and almost
always bring stolen shipments home with them. Find the post box, steal back the cargo. Simple as that. But be careful, these guys are armed. If this goes sideways, be ready to fight.
Yes, sir. Yep. You got it. What I was saying is that I'll finish this mission, see what it tells me next, and then maybe call it an episode. And then we can continue on next episode. Ooh. Can rock climb. Awesome. That was helpful. Thank you. So let's build one right. Oh, I see a dude right there. So get another watchtower built.
Come on, hurry up.
Being sucked in, it's crazy.
Construction complete.
Let's use this bad boy. That's it.
job sites are rarely deserted, so remaining undetected is key. Keep a low profile and move slowly to minimize noise.
Seems like everybody was going up this way, so let's give it a look. He's giving me directions and everything. Many places here at all, huh? Or if it was too rocky to do that, maybe? Tall grass over here. Yeah, buddy. Boys. Dude is like, that's too much. All right, so let's offload some of this. My bad. that's a little bit better for my dude. Yeah, because I want to take, this guy out too.
Seems all the mules in your vicinity have been incapacitated.
That's good. Taking out all these mules. Excuse me.
There we go. There we go.
I'll use some repair spray when I get down there, just to make sure we're all good. Doing good, man. Making some progress. That's all we gotta do. Progress, progress.
Damn addicts chasing a cargo high. Shame we gotta deal with their bullshit at all. Back in the day, AI did everything. Deliveries were handled by unmanned vehicles and drones. And all we had to do was sit back and let them work. It was revolutionary. Damn near singularity. No reason for it not to take off. But it didn't. People didn't like it when we took the human element out of the service industry. So, after some consideration, we put it back in. Made jobs really? No one really needed and gave them to folks who couldn't live without them. And from there, it snowballed. Now we got cults of cargo-chasing crazies who get off on hijacking shipments. Jackal's always on the lookout for the next porter. Make sure you're not him.
There we go. Let's make my climb a little bit easier.
bit further now.
This is gonna sound funny, but I actually like leaving tools for other people. It's again something else that's been like pretty cool. Kojima must have been on to something. It's not just a walking or a FedEx simulator. This is... Bravo, sir.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. All weapons will remain locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you.
You're welcome. Be like my whistle.
Decontaminating suit. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Thank you, sir.
Shoes holding up? Not too well, I imagine, conditions being what they are out there. Nothing ruins your day like shoes falling apart while you're on the job. Carry on like that, and it's only a matter of time before you injure yourself. I've arranged for boots to be added to your supplies. Bridges standard issue, so they ought to fit you fine. You should always carry an extra pair. But if you forget or run into trouble, you can fabricate another via a terminal at one of our many facilities.
I can create a bridge now.
See you around.
Congratulations, Sam. I understand you now have access to an extraordinarily useful device that can only function because of the manner in which our network utilizes the beach, enabling us to transfer massive volumes of data instantaneously. Since under normal circumstances, such transfers would take hours, if not days, some have speculated that the chiral network might, in essence, be a time machine. That it is transmitting data into the past. Suffice it to say, we have yet to fully grasp the fundamental nature of the network and the beach which we have come to rely on.
One might liken our relationship with it to that of primitive mammals with fire. Is it useful? Quite. Is it dangerous? Undeniably so. Nevertheless, we have decided that the reward outweighs the risk. Furthermore, as the BTs are linked to the beach, it stands to reason that further study and experimentation could be of considerable benefit. The same could be said regarding you, of course. Rest assured, I will keep you apprised of what I learn. You have my word.
Good work. New order available.
Thank you.
Please access delivery terminal.
We've added a bridge schematic to your PCC. Plenty of rivers and canyons could do with a good bridge, you know. Take a stroll across one you built yourself, and I guarantee you'll be glad you made the effort.
That's right.
Give it a try.
Thank you. Okay.
Your work is great.
No, let's get some private room.
Yes.
And I think, yeah, what I'll do is go to the private room and then see if there's any story. He's tired. He's dog tired.
Good morning, Sam.
Good morning. Let's make sure he's clean. So let's get some more stamina, and then I'm gonna call it an episode, guys. I don't think we're gonna have much more. Please let me know if you guys enjoyed the episode. Comment down below, leave a like, subscribe, and share. That way we can continue to grow this community. All right, guys. And with that, I'm going to leave this as our ending screen. Look into some Monster Energy drinks. Appreciate you watching. Have a great night, and God bless you all.